this video, we're diving into the exciting world of low-fidelity wireframing using Miro and Sketch. Wireframing is a crucial step in the UX design process, allowing us to visualize the structure and functionality of our designs without getting bogged down in the details. Today, we'll explore how to efficiently create low-fidelity wireframes using the tools and components available in Miro and Sketch. Before we jump in, let's quickly discuss what low-fidelity wireframes are. Think of them as the skeleton of your design. They focus on layout and functionality rather than aesthetics. This approach allows us to iterate quickly and gather feedback early in the design process. Let's start by opening your Greenleaf Grocers board and creating a new frame called Wireframes. This will be our canvas for sketching out the initial ideas. Now, switch over to Sketch and open a new document and set up your artboards. For desktop designs, a great template to use is the MacBook Pro 13-inch template, which is found under Apple Devices towards the bottom. The first wireframe I'm going to create is Home, so I'll rename this artboard Home. In Miro, we'll begin by using the Shapes tool to create basic wireframe elements. We can use the Rectangle tool to draw placeholders for images and text blocks. I'll go ahead and finish this one off screen. Remember, at this stage, we're focusing on the layout. Don't worry about colors or detailed graphics. Keep it simple and clear. Once you have a rough layout in Miro, it's time to move to Sketch for more detailed wireframes. In Sketch, similar to Miro, we'll use the Shape tool to draw simple elements. We can add text layers for labels. And use rectangles and text boxes to create buttons. Sketch's symbols feature is incredibly useful here. Create reusable symbols for elements like buttons and navigation bars to maintain consistency across your wireframes. To do this, select the elements you want to turn into a symbol and make sure they're grouped. Then right-click and click Create Symbol. This will save a symbol in a new page marked Symbols. This means that if I were to make changes, say adding more pages, those changes will be applied to my wireframe automatically. Let's go ahead and finish our wireframes. Wireframing is an iterative process. Use feedback from peers or stakeholders to refine your designs. In Sketch, you can easily duplicate artboards to create variations and explore different design solutions. You can also duplicate pages to create different iterations of your work. Right-click on a page and select Duplicate. Remember to keep your user flow in mind as you iterate. Each screen should guide the user intuitively through the website. We have just completed a comprehensive approach to creating low-fidelity wireframes using Miro and Sketch. By focusing on structure and functionality, we can quickly iterate and improve our designs. In the next activity, you'll apply these techniques to continue to create wireframes for the Greenleaf Grocers website. Happy designing!